talking to the Rolex. Wearing diamond ring, wearing gift dealer. Woo, wheel of dealer. Limousine wreck, jet flying, son of a gun. And I'm having a hard time holding these alligators down. Woo.
They call me Hot Rod. Everybody knows it. I don't have to say what I am, because I've done it. That's the difference between you and me. You talk about it, I do it.
You will know that your ass is mine, and that's the bottom line, because those don't get some.
Thank you. Thank you for the ovation. Yes.
Before we hear Daddy talk, welcome to the East Side David Southwestern Show. Sorry to cut you off. Go ahead. I mean, actually, I'm not sorry. Go ahead.
Stanley Mac is already getting in on the backstabbing. Stanley Mac is already getting in on the heel turn. How about giving us a big, huge introduction here, okay?
Welcome to the East Side.
More.
Welcome to the East Side.
More.
Welcome to the East Side, Dave and Son, Wessel and So.
And I heard that this podcast, as far as father-son wrestling podcasts go, is the best in the world. Is that correct? So maybe you should say it.
We are the best in the world.
Not so good. Let's try harder. Let's try better. A little more enthusiasm. A little more volume. Thank you. Number two, let's go.
We are in the best in the world.
Put your heart into it. So far, I'm nonplussed by the lack of excitement in your voice. Really dig in. Let's go. Come on.
We are the best in the world. Shane McMahon.
Shane. Well, we were ripping off Shane McMahon, clearly, and so we were giving a little tribute to Shane there, and yes, we are the best in the world. As far as father-son wrestling podcasts go, I think we are, and it's the Eastside David Son Wrestling Show, and we do this before every big-time WWE pay-per-view, and tonight, Sunday, June 23rd, 2019, it's Stomping Grounds. Now, is this the first ever WWE Stomping Ground, Stanley?
Yes.
As far as I know, right? It's not, I don't think we've seen this before.
There's never been a WWE Stomping Ground, never.
It's always fun when they have one of those new pay-per-views like Great Balls of Fire, which I thought turned out to be an excellent pay-per-view.
Stomping Ground, but like, I don't feel like what we're going to be, I feel like we...
You think Stomping Ground's a one and done?
Actually, I was going to say that, but I changed my, I think like... The Stomping Grounds is going to be like a Great Balls Fire, except one difference.
What?
That there will be another Stomping Ground.
Okay. So you think it's going to be nothing like Great Balls of Fire, which was a one and done, because you think they're going to have another Stomping Grounds?
Yeah.
Okay. So in other words, they actually have nothing in common. But thank you for your analysis, I guess is what you could say. Okay. Listen. We could sit here, we could talk turkey, okay? Specifically turkey on wheat with a nice slice of tomato and some lettuce. I also like a little bit of mayonnaise, not a lot, Stanley. But we could sit here and we could talk turkey. In fact, how are you? You know, school's almost ending for you, right?
Yeah.
When's the last day of school?
The last day of school is 2 days.
On Tuesday?
Yeah. And Daddy,
yes?
Can I tell you something that we learned in school? What's 1 plus 1?
I believe 2 is 1 plus 1. Aren't you a little bit old to be learning such a simple arithmetic problem?
No, because...
You're 10, right?
I think you think that's probably like 178.
How old are you now?
10.
You had to think about it, too. Stanley's 10 years old, and that's why I do consider you to be probably the first and foremost wrestling analyst at the age of 10, of course. Now, here we go. Should we get right into it? Okay. And then, you know why? Because we got a big New York Yankees Houston Astros game. I also wanted to play some wiffle ball myself, perhaps a home run derby or two. And so let's get into it. We're going to do 8 Stomping Grounds matches this evening. And we're going to start right off the bat. Yes?
Before you say anything, we're actually going to be doing 8 out of 9.
8 out of 9. We're not going to do the Cruiserweight Championship, which is Tony Nese versus Drew Gulak versus Tozawa. I mean, quite frankly, we don't care about that. But we are going to do the other matches, and that starts right now. Samoa Joe, your United States champion, takes on Ricochet in what I think is going to be a very promising, a very interesting matchup. Stanley Mac, thoughts and opinions. Let's go.
I think Joe's great is 2-time, but this is the thing. I mean, Ricochet seems like a guy that would beat Joe to become it. That's why I'm going with Ricochet.
Stanley Mac going with Ricochet, the smaller but more athletic, more high-flying, more gravity-defying wrestler, and that is Ricochet. Listen, Stan, I love it. I love your attitude. I love your philosophy. I love everything. Unfortunately, you're 100% wrong. You're a dope. Samoa Joe is going to retain the United States Championship. He's going to defeat Ricochet. But I do think Ricochet is he's going up. He's going places. He has a very, very bright future. I just don't think his time is now, so to speak. To reference John Cena. Right, Stanley?
Yeah.
Stanley, whatever happened to John Cena? Is he retired or something?
Well, John Cena, there's in Nickelodeon's, he's actually going to be hosting a show in Nickelodeon's. So
he's going to be hosting a show on Nickelodeon's.
So he's probably going to be busy doing that.
Here's the thing about John Cena's show on Nickelodeon. It's that I hear it doesn't get good ratings because no one can see it. Get it?
Yep.
Next match. So I'm going with Samoa Joe. Next match is going to be, how about this one? This is good. Let's get a little tag team activity right now. The New Day, Big E and Xavier Woods versus Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn. Like it. Who do you like, New Day or KO and Sammy?
And Sami Zayn. But before you say, you're gonna see why later. You're gonna see why later.
Okay. But so for now, you like Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn to defeat the New Day.
Yeah.
Okay. You know what? I'm going with you on that one. I am. For once in our gosh darn lives, we agree on something. And that is that Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn will defeat the New Day. Let's stay with a tag team match here. And let's go with your SmackDown tag team champions, Daniel Bryan and Rowan, versus Heavy Machinery, Otis and Tucker. This is for the SmackDown tag team championship, Stanley.
This is tough, actually.
Go for it. I'm waiting.
Rowan and Daniel.
Rowan and Daniel?
Actually? Otis and Tucker. Crazy.
You're going with Heavy Machinery and an upset special?
Because Bryan, I think, is going to be solo.
Okay, so Stanley thinks that because Daniel Bryan's going to go solo again, that Heavy Machinery will take the tag team championship. Stanley, one of the things about you that I've witnessed is that you have like 3 brain cells. And, that's not a lot. So oftentimes you make, let's be honest, pretty poor predictions, in my opinion. Very bad prognostications. You're like a inaccurate Nostradamus. However, you have gotten one thing right today, and that is Upset City. Heavy Machinery does in fact defeat Daniel Bryan and Rowan for the WWE SmackDown Tag Team Championships, I'm a believer. In fact, dare I say, I want to be in the Otis fan club. They remind me a little bit of an old school Hart Foundation with Bret Hart, you know, with Tucker being kind of Bret Hartish, and then Otis as sort of the Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Maybe a little bit of Hart Foundation mixed with the Bushwhackers is the way I see Heavy Machinery. And I think the WWE Universe sees the same thing. I think that they're over, and they think, you know what, why not? What do you got to lose? Give them the tag team championship belts. So I agree with you.
Yeah.
Is that a shocker? All right, let's go with a women's match now, Stanley Mac. And let's go with Bayley, your WWE SmackDown Women's Champion, versus Alexa Bliss. Interesting matchup. I have sort of enjoyed this storyline, combined with the addition of Nikki Cross. I feel like it's been a pretty interesting storyline. I'm not exactly sure what they're doing, and that's a good thing. Sort of unpredictable. Who do you like?
I'll tell you, I think Bayley will win, and after, I think Bayley's also, and then she hits Alexa Bliss with a chair and turns heel.
Okay, so you think that Bayley's going to turn heel. Yeah. I could see Bayley turning heel, believe it or not. I think they've sort of been hinting that she's getting a little bit full of herself, it seems. A little ego. Or me and you are just totally misreading it. But I think you're right. I think Bayley's going to retain the SmackDown Women's Championship. But I think that we have not seen the end of this story. I don't know what factor Nikki Cross is going to play in this. But I do think she's going to be a factor indeed. But I think you're right. Bayley's going to win this one. Let's go with another match. Stanley Mac. And that is Roman Reigns versus Drew McIntyre, straight up singles match. Who do you like?
Roman Reigns.
Roman Reigns?
Yeah.
I disagree. I think that you have marbles for brains. I think that I should pretty much take your brains, put them on a piece of bread with some peanut butter, and make a nice sandwich, because you have jelly for brains. Where your brains should be, in fact, it's just grape jelly, because Drew McIntyre will, in fact, win this match. Give a win to the Scottish psychopath, Drew McIntyre, as he defeats Roman Reigns. And Drew McIntyre is on his way to a WWE Universal Championship.
I like where you're going. Just, can I check your brain? I saw you, and I opened up your head, and I saw you had M&Ms in your brain.
I had M&Ms in my brain?
Yes.
Hold on. My brain tastes delicious. All right, Stan. We got to go on to the next match. And the next match is a big time match. It's Becky Lynch. Becky Lynch, your WWE Raw Women's Championship. She now goes by Becky Redbelt. And Becky Lynch takes on Lacey Evans, the sassy Southern Belle, a character straight out of 1987. I don't mind Lacey Evans. I would like her to begin talking a little quicker. I think the pacing of her promos are a little slow. Let's make her talk a little faster, a little urgency to the Lacey Evans character, because quite frankly, when she's talking so slowly, it makes me think, why would she even want to be a wrestler in the first place? She clearly wants to be, I don't know, drinking iced tea in her hammock in Georgia or something. I think Becky Lynch wins this match. I don't think Lacey Evans is going to be the champion just yet.
Becky wins.
Becky Lynch?
Yes, way.
Yeah, I don't see it happening. I think if you're going to go away from Becky Lynch, you want something big. And we're so close to SummerSlam that maybe, you know, that's where Becky Lynch loses her championship.
I thought about this. What? I was thinking of, unless there's a new pay-per-view, I don't remember an old pay-per-view being before SummerSlam. Now that I think about it.
Well, the Great Balls of Fire was right before SummerSlam.
Yes, but do you think that they're going to do that again?
No, they're not going to do that again. All right, let's go into the next one, and let's go for the WWE Championship here. Kofi Kingston, your WWE Champion versus Dolph Ziggler. It should have been me. Dolph Ziggler has come back to the WWE very jealous, filled with envy and rage. He feels like he's been the guy who should have gotten that championship, not Kofi Kingston. What do you think here, Stanley? Kofi or Dolph?
Now I can tell you why I predict the New Day to win that tag team. Because the New Day, I think it's going to be 1-1. They're going to win one, lose one. So the New Day woos to Kevin, Sami, so Kofi Kingston can beat Dolph Ziggler and be still your WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Oh, I like that. I agree with you. Kofi's not losing this. He's not losing this to Dolph. I'm sorry. I sort of like the angle with Ziggler being filled with rage and whatnot. I believe in it. But I still don't think Dolph is going to win. Okay, thank you very much. Next match, final match. Wow, this one moved by very quickly. Seth Rollins, your WWE Universal Champion versus Baron Corbin for the Universal Championship. By the way, we must factor this in to be announced at the pay-per-view itself. The special guest referee as appointed by Baron Corbin. That's important to keep in mind. Now, Corbin had made C-3PO, that one guy who looks like a combination of The Rock versus John Cena. What's that one wrestler's name, C-3PO?
EC3,
that's what I said, EC-3PO. He made that guy, doesn't he look like a combination of The Rock and John Cena? Like he could have been their baby if they were parents and had a little baby together. So I did, originally it was going to be EC-3PO, who was going to be the special guest referee, but Seth Rollins hit him in the back with a chair, so he's out. Then they were going to give it to Elias. Seth Rollins hit him in with a chair. One of the guys from Insanity was going to be a ref, but Seth Rollins attacked him with a chair. So we don't know who the special guest referee is. Any guesses before we get into the prediction for the match itself? Any guess as to who? Because I have a guess right now.
You know what I think we will be? This is a friendship. This is a friendship that will never ever end.
Bray Wyatt as the special guest referee. What an interesting decision, Stan. Okay, wow. You know, I had not thought about that. How about this? What? For special guest referee, how much sense does this make? Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar becomes the special guest referee.
Champion, I know.
And then cashes in the money in the bank.
No, but then it's like, it's too obvious he's going to do it. That's why they're not going to do that.
All right.
We're done with the show, everybody.
Your prediction. Oh, jeez. Stanley Mac calling it an end to the show. How about giving us a couple impressions or two before we wrap it up here? Anything? Anything for the audience? Go ahead.
Oh,
go ahead, please.
Oh, you're not. Bray Wyatt, I'm coming for you.
Ooh.
I'm coming for you at WrestleMania.
Ooh, I like this.
You know what this is from?
Absolutely not.
Remember the, when he burned down the, boyfriend and he said, I'm coming for you. I'm coming for your title.
Is that Randy Orton?
Yeah, when he burned down Bray Wyatt's house.
Okay.
That's my impression.
Good. That's your impression? That was Randy Orton?
Yeah.
All right, let's give another one. One more before we hit the road and put another beautiful bow on this epic episode of the Eastside Dave and Son Wrestling Show. Come on. Give us something special here. A little Macho Man, maybe? Stone Cold? Piper? Ric Flair? Bobby Heenan? Georgie Amel Steel? Jake Snake Roberts?
Woo! Kiss Stealing? Women's in Rye? And we've only just begun.
Oh, nice. Ric Flair?
Yeah.
Okay, fantastic. Well, listen, we want you to enjoy WWE Stomping Grounds. As for the East Side Dave and Son Wrestling Show, my name is Davey Mac. He is Stanley Mac. Have a great night watching your wrestling, everybody. See you later.